graduated medicine in 1966, I started implanting pacemakers in 1970 at the Royal Melbourne Hospital. Pacemakers were first used in Australia. In 1929, Mark C. Lidwell implanted a needle into the heart of a stillborn baby, and as a result of this, he managed to get the heart working. It was the first case and is acknowledged in the literature today. In those early days at the Royal Melbourne Hospital in 1959, Dr. Graham Sloman really started cardiology. Very few physicians around the world were performing cardiac pacing. And it was even before I joined the department, he convinced me to start the pacemaker clinic. His influence was absolutely profound.
The treatment of sudden death with the heart no longer beating was the thing that we were concentrating on for the first few years.
I and others had designed a technique where we made an incision under the collarbone and found a vein and thread a wire into the heart, and in this way we could pace the heart. Pacemakers were actually built by our electronic engineering department. They would take a small amount of electronics and they would pot it in an epoxy resin, and presto, we had a pacemaker to implant.
It was a gradual process with pacemakers, initially external, but eventually was put in internally. At that stage, pacemakers were not really considered as a medical device.
I first became involved in pacemaking in 1964 as a consequence of being a partner in a small engineering company manufacturing electronic devices. And I was introduced to a chief of cardiothoracic surgery at Royal Prince Alfred Hospital in Sydney, who explained to me that he was having trouble with his new devices, which he called heart batteries. That's how it all started.
Jeff Wickham of Teletronics is a legend in pacing and had the idea of developing a pacemaker to stimulate the heart.
Initially, the pacemaker was a fairly bulky object, and it was inevitable that evolution would lead it to a smaller pacemaker. The challenge was to find out how to do it.
This is one of our earliest pacemakers, and here is one of the currently produced mini models. This miniaturisation will naturally make for much greater comfort.
Australia was in the forefront in those early years, and Teletronics did play a very important part. Then we became comfortable using a device that we knew was reliable.
You can take this home. This will check your pacemaker yourself. Press the button or put it on the back of your hand, it doesn't matter. And there we are, 72.4. Yes, lovely.
The ideas that came out once they had developed the first pacemakers were remarkable.
The evolutionary milestones were, first of all, in 1969, the change from discrete circuitry to a microcircuit. The other big problem was the plastics. Epoxy resin is permeable to water vapour, and that leads to corrosion and, of course, electronic failure. We overcame that by developing a sealed welded titanium case. We were the first in the world to do that. At that same stage in 1971, a pacemaker battery was developed by one Wilson Greatbatch called a lithium iodide cell, and that produced a massive step forward in reliability.
It was very important in that instead of having a need to put a new pacemaker in every 3 to 6 months, the pacemakers were lasting for up to 10 years.
We now push the wire as far as the heart. And now we place the pulse generator inside a little prepared pocket. It just pops in like that. And we are ready now to close up the wound. Then after that, Teletronics developed minute ventilation technology, which allowed the pacing rate to increase according to an increasing exercise. I look back very fondly on my association with patients and the lives that I improved in these people. To follow them for over 20 years is a great inspiration for me.
Your pacemaker is a triumph of collaboration between modern medicine and electronic technology.
establishing the cardiac clinic was a very important milestone for the development of pacemakers.
Australians have always been natural innovators. We've challenged ourselves to meet objectives beyond what was being achieved overseas.
And it was the engineers' ideas and their ability to put it into practice that really changed the face of cardiac pacing.